Now, if you were to slice up a mature root, you would see a specific type of organization of those tissues in the root. So I want to show it to you. And the type of organization depends on whether the plant, we're talking about angiosperm plants here, whether the plant is a monocot, that is, just has one seed leaf like corn does in its seed, or a dicot like a bean or a peanut where the seed can be split into two parts. So monocot or dicot can also be identified based on the organization of the cells in the root. So let's take a look. Here's the outside of the root, and let's say that the yellow part that I've just put down are epidermal cells, and you know in a root, the epidermis is going to have root hairs as extensions of the cell membrane out into the soil. So those are the root hairs. The epidermis is typically just one layer of cells thick. So I'm just putting a second line here and showing our second layer of cells. Now, I'm going to draw now the vascular system, and in a dicot, the xylem tissue tends to be shaped a bit like an X right in the middle of the root, a little bit X-shaped. That's the xylem. X-Y-L-E-M. The phloem can be found typically in those pockets of the X. So this is phloem. And between them, remember the third type of cell in the vascular tissue is cambium, which is a meristematic cell. And if you see cambium, it will be lying between the phloem and the xylem. Phloem, by the way, is always oriented toward the outside of the plant stem or root, and the xylem toward the inside. The vascular system has, as its furthest outside layer of cells, a layer of cells called the pericycle. It's part of the vascular system, and it's where lateral roots originate. So there's a picture of that in your lesson. But if there are going to be lateral roots coming off this particular part of this root, it's going to originate from the pericycle. Just outside of the pericycle, is a layer of cortex cells that's called the endodermis. E-N-D-O-D-E-R-M-I-S. It's part of the cortex. The endodermis cells have around the cells a strip of suberin that makes it waterproof so that water can't get between the cells. Water has to move through the cells. And this strip is called the Casparian strip, C-A-S, Casparian strip. Which looks a little bit pink in this diagram, but again, it's suberin around each cell that waterproofs it, so water has to go through the cell. The rest of these cells here are typically parenchyma cells, and our cortex cells. So when water moves into a root, the water molecules move into the protuberances of the epidermis, the root hairs, move into the epidermal cells. And then water can take two paths. It can either move between the parenchyma cells, or it can go cell to cell within the parenchyma until it reaches the endodermis. And there it encounters, if it's trying to move between the cells, it encounters the Casparian strip, which doesn't let it go any further between cells. So the water has to move into the cell to cross the trans, the Casparian strip in order to move into the xylem and then move up the plant. So this Casparian strip allows the cells in the endodermis to be gatekeepers for water moving into the xylem part of the vascular system.